Bark, 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 bark!
Chicken here, bring you another Boom Beach video. So in today's video, guys, if you couldn't tell already, it is the wig and lipstick video. Those are some hashtag kisses for turtle, guys. So in today's video, I wanted to do a... well, first of all, I wanted to give a shout out to Turtle for doing the challenge. We both had fun with it, so hopefully we can do more of those in the future, guys. And I guess I should explain this wig. I couldn't actually find, I went to like 4 different stores this morning and I couldn't find an actual like wig to use, so I just went with this. And I hope that's alright with Mr. Tortoise. Bark, bark, bark. So we're going to be, we've got the all tanks loaded up, guys. We're going to be doing a little bit of some map clearing here. So again, I apologize, but my fingers go in front of the camera. There's just like, there's no way around doing that with the setup I have right now. It's just, it's just what it is for now. Like I said before, actually I'm going to discuss my future plans for the channel later on. So what I did also want to say in this video, I wanted to do a subscriber shout out. We recently just hit 300 subs, which I know isn't like a big deal, but I wanted to do like a subscriber like thank you, and I wanted to let you guys know whenever I do something like this, like whenever we hit a hashtag chicken channel milestone, I'm gonna do some sort of subscriber shout out. And eventually I'd like to get into like doing giveaways and stuff. Oh, this space is gonna be brutal. 2 grapplers. We'll give it a go, guys. We'll give it a go. Again, sorry for my thumbs and stuff being in the way. But, okay, so we're gonna launch the tanks out like this. I think I'm gonna take out the grapplers. We should have enough GBE to just kind of burn right through them. Okay. So, it sucks we couldn't use that for boom cannons, but, it is what it is, guys. It is what it is. Okay, so, yeah, I wanted to do a couple of subscriber shoutouts. So how this is going to work is, whenever we hit a channel milestone, I'm just going to, like, maybe highlight some comments or, just, like, generally shout out, two of the most, frequent, subscribers that I see, down in the comments. So, number one is going to be Marty, aka Marty Jishin. I'm not sure how you actually say your name, so I'm sorry if I messed that up. But he's actually got his own YouTube channel, guys. And if you've seen the Funny Chicken Highlights video, which I highly recommend you check out, you should definitely give his channel a look over. But yeah, he's always posting funny stuff down in the comments. He's having a... taking a go at chicken here and there, which is always good to see. Okay, so we're gonna be clearing out this one, and if I can find a way, I'll link some of his comments. Like, I'll like post them into the video if I can figure out how to do that. Back, 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 and yeah, the next guy I wanted to shout out was again. Sorry if I get your name wrong. I'm not always sure how to say these names. Where should we go next here, guys? The Big Boss. Actually, we can just dime them up as we go, because it is hashtag Tankmania. So, the amount of... I don't have a ton of diamonds right now, but it should be, like... it should be enough to clear my map, unless we get some, like, crazy stupid ice bases with, like, doom cannons and stuff. Oh, spoke too soon, guys. Spoke too soon. Literally a boosted ice base with a doom cannon. That's funny. But yeah, the next guy I wanted to shout out was Everardo. I call him Evie sometimes, so we'll just go with Evie. So big shout out to Evie. He's usually down in the comments making fun of the chicken noises and stuff. So big shout out to you. And eventually, guys, once we get to a point where we're larger than we are now, I'll do like... I'd love to do it right now, some sort of, like, giveaway or something, but obviously I can't because we're just, like, too small, and I can't do that stuff right now. But, yeah, it's just something to look forward to if you plan on hashtag sticking around with the chicken guys. Back, back, back. Okay, and, And I'm also going to do a thing called the Worst Comment Award. This is just for, like, the when we hit the subscriber milestones I'm talking about. We're going to do this. We're losing some tanks here at the Doom County, guys. Should probably focus up a little bit here. So the Worst Comment Award goes to, I don't know the guy's name. Don't really want to shout him out either, because he's probably a troll. So, he just said in the turtle vid, he was like, chicken has no chance, and he suck with Zuka. And he suck with Zuka. So I don't know, I thought that was kind of funny and random, so we'll give a little troll shout out there. Okay, are we going to have enough to finish this up, guys? I am going to get into an all-tank operation attack. I asked the guys in my task force if that was going to be alright, and they never got back to me, so I guess it's alright. Are we not going to do this? Come on, tanks, let's go here. 4 freaking boosted damage statues, let's go. Okay, one more shot, come on. Oh my god. Are you kidding me? That's fine. We should probably actually focus a little bit here on the attacks. I'm not sure what it costs. It's only 24 diamonds to retrain them all, so whatever, that's nothing. So yeah, we'll go back into Big Boss here, guys, and we'll get a little hashtag Chicken Revenge going. So I'm gonna go to one of the sides. I think I'm gonna take out this Doom Cannon. There's no point in taking out all those Boom Cannons first. That was kind of a waste. We'll throw a couple. Holy jeez, that's got some health on it, guys. Okay, so we're gonna go from the left. First, I'm gonna take down the shock launcher, and my plan is I can shock most of those cannons with one shock bomb, so I'm not really going to have to spend GB to take them out, I don't think. I'm not sure how much it costs to land them all. 6 times 8. Again, not a scientist, so just bear with me on that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, and we're going to shock right there. Okay, so I think this is going to go a little better, because we kind of took on, like, everything all at once in the last attack, so definitely try not to attack like that. This would also be easier if I had medics. Like, tanks on their own are kind of junky. But, I mean, I do have, like, 10 statues boosted, so We shouldn't have too many hashtag chicken excuses today, guys. Okay, I'm gonna throw some critters down there. Okay, so it looks like we are gonna be able to take this down this time. That shock launcher could mess us up a little bit. I could use another shock bomb right now. That'd be really, really nice. Okay. Take out that boom cannon. Where should we go here next? I need some more GB. If I can get one shock bomb, we'll be okay. Take out the flamethrower. Okay, what are we gonna do here? What are we going to do? I think I'm gonna throw down the critters, because I got nothing else left. And if that distracts for a little bit, like, we should be able to blast through this, like, pretty quickly. Bark, bark, bark. Okay, so is it gonna go down? That boom cannon is in range. We just need a couple more shots, guys. Come on. Let's go. One more. Boom. Okay, all right. That was a little sketchy, but we made it through, guys. Only cost us 24 diamonds, so not the end of the world. Back. Yeah, so we got hammering down today, so why don't we do that next? And while we wait for the tanky tanks to load back up. I've been having great success with the hot pot and the shield generator combination. I'm going to show you guys a couple defenses here. I actually won a defense this morning. I couldn't believe it. I've won two defenses in like the last week or so. Or like since whenever I put the hot pot and shield generator down. So I think I've only won like maybe 5 defenses my entire time playing this game. So, just goes to show, guys. I think he must have screwed something up here. Let's see where he puts his shocks. Oops. So, one... Yeah, see, he didn't have enough to shock the shock launcher, so that just messed him up. Because I think, I don't know, he did shock the shock launchers. Did one of them shock him at first? I don't know. Something bad happened. So he gets the shield generator down. And then the hot pot just goes to work. Just goes to work on the warriors. Look at that! Like, they only needed, like, 2 more shots with all of them up, and it rips them apart before they can even do it. Okay, we'll speed it up now. But, yeah. I'm definitely enjoying the hot pot so far, guys. So let me know in the comments how your tank mania is going. We're gonna be loading up the Hammerman stage. I think I need to actually put some time in and make like a half decent Hammerman stage. So with the shield generator, we can put the HQ a little closer. I'm not sure exactly how I want to work this. I think I might put the rockets like something like this. Okay, move you back. It seems like my layout always gets like super messed up whenever I switch it and have different prototypes. Like it's just always like super different than how it was when I first made it. Okay, so I think this will be okay regardless for like the first two or three stages, I think. Alright, so what do you got for us today, Hammer? Hammerhead. Tanks, Warriors, this should be melted pretty quickly. Hopefully we don't get trolled by the Grens on the beach this time. If you saw the video where I actually took down Hammerman for the first time, there was like two or three stages where there was like one Grenadier on the beach just like shooting at nothing. And I just had like nothing in range of him. So he just sat there for like 2 minutes, so hopefully we don't get any of those. Wow, you see them just walk in the hot pot and they just die like instantly. There's like nothing they can do. I find the heavies are actually the worst for the hot pot, because they can actually like, he sends so many out that they actually do like a fair amount of damage. And the hot pot can't really it does do work on them, but it can't just like rip through them obviously like riflemen or whatever. So it actually like takes a minute to take them all down, and usually they can take it out before that happens. So yeah, if we can avoid the heavies, that would be nice. The Grens first is okay. I think I have the shock launchers. Yeah, I think I have the shock launchers positioned just for that reason I said before, so we don't get any Grens stuck right on the very front of the beach. That is always annoying. Yeah, like right there. I also have the rocket launcher in the back too, so we should be good. As far as Gren trolling, we should be okay, guys. Alrighty. So stage 4, guys. Hopefully we can take him down today, because I'm kind of, I was going to say I'm kind of losing prototypes, but like I'm not really. I still have like more than 150 of all of them. Back. Even like the power rods, which I was always struggling to get, since I've been using hot pots instead of, I used to always go Doom Cannon 3 and Damage Amp 3. And obviously that was like 15 power rods or something stupid. I think the hot pot's only 6, and like whatever else I use isn't going to be like that big of a deal. So I find it's actually easier on the prototype things. We'll show you a glimpse here. Yeah, so apparently I never use these field capacitors. Power rods are staying alive. Yeah, because the hot pot's what, 6? Oh, it's only 3 power rods, okay. So that's why. Yeah, because I used to only use the Doom Cannon, which was 9, and the Damage Amp, which was 6. So I was, like, always low on power rods. Like, not low, but, like, low in comparison to everything else. Yeah, so I find the new prototypes, they're actually, like, they're obviously like 10 times better, and it's like easier on the modules. And since I never really used, like I didn't use them a lot, it was only whenever I was really needed the intel that I would use them. So I had like a good stash of them already to begin with. But anyways guys, back. Okay, so we're on stage 4 here? Stage 4 or 5, I'm not sure. Either way, it's going down, guys, it's going down. These freaking medics. Look at them. They're following one Zooka. Okay, Hammerman. What's the plan here? Oh, this is stupid. Just step on the mine. You're right there. Okay. Do I actually have to kill the medics? Oh, that's ridiculous. That is ridiculous. Okay. Okay, medics, you've made your point. It's medic trolling. That's the new thing. Before it was Grens, now it's medics. That's so stupid. Okay. Alright, so stage 5 or stage 4 goes down? That was stage 5. Alright, so on to stage 6. We didn't really have much trouble with that either, other than the stupid medics at the end. So, we're looking okay. The real test is 6, though, just like Dr. Terrence. Doesn't really start till 6. Okay, so we got the grands in the back getting shocked. It's alright. We might be better off putting the hot pot on the left side. Okay, now bringing in the heavies. Okay, so this could get a little dicey, guys. Depends if he's got another boatload. They're not going to do much work. I got the grands in the back. Okay. So we're gonna try this one more time, guys. Actually, we'll leave it for now. Maybe we'll do it at the end of the video. That's okay for right now. We're gonna be diamonding up the tanks again and be getting into some more player bases, I think. Yeah, because if you notice, I didn't put a video out yesterday, so I wasn't really playing that much. So we got a lot of map clearing left to do. We're just gonna find a new one, not worried about that. May goof, guys. Alrighty, so what's the plan here? He's got 2 hot pots, which is okay. We're just gonna launch him out right here. The only thing I don't like using about tanks is how slow they are. It's just like super annoying, I find. Especially for map clearing, because it just takes like twice as long. Like, if I was doing this with warriors, I could just smash down bases. Is this guy boosted ice or something? Okay, he's got 2, 4, 6 ice. Okay. Alright, so this isn't going to be a hashtag walk in the chicken coop today. 6 ice versus all tanks. You can tell they're not that good even with all my statue boosts. They're still not, like, it might just be the way I'm using them, I guess, but, there's definitely better options for fully boosted to map clear with, but they are fun to use for sure. I would recommend if you're not experienced with tanks, like tanks alone. Like I really like Scorcher tank. I don't think anyone ever uses that. Obviously, tank using 3 boats of medics is the way to go, because then you're like basically invincible to rocket launchers and like splash damage and stuff like that. It even helps with it even helps with cannons and stuff, because if the cannon switches targets, then you're going to be able to heal them in between. But I mean, if even like a normal cannon shoots at you twice, you're probably going to go down. Alrighty, guys, so this guy actually went down a lot easier than the other guy, and I don't think. Well, he had boosted ice, so it's probably about relatively the same. Oh, our first disconnect, guys. That's exciting. The first disconnect of the day. So, I think that still counts as taking him down. Someone told me in the comments the other day when that happens, obviously you don't get to see the replay, but, okay, we're gonna find a new one. I think we attacked this guy before and failed. but you just don't get the supply chest VP for it. When that happens. Oh, I guess it's Hammerman today, right? So, I'm actually surprised there's not more people boosting their ice. 1, 2, 3, okay. Alrighty, 1, 2, 3, 4. I should probably go ahead and just throw in a boat of medics, guys. But, we started with the all tanks, we're gonna finish with the all tanks, guys. Plus, I'm gonna get into an operation attack here in a minute, so, That's gonna be dicey for sure. We're only doing Stronghold right now. I'm not sure why. I haven't really talked to my guys much, but I'm assuming it's just for... it's because we don't have any intel. That's why. We wanted to start Dead End or something, but I think we only had like 260 intel or something like that. Okay, so... Does this guy have any ice? No, just the 2. Okay, shock that hot pot immediately. I'm gonna be throwing some critters down. Now, you see, I don't really re-flare the tanks much. That's just because it takes them. I think I've spoken about this before. It just takes them so long to start shooting again that it's not really worth it, in my opinion, to do it all the time. Because you're gonna lose like 2 or 3, like just on the walk over, if there's a cannon in range and you can't like smoke them or anything. Alrighty. Return. Okay, so let's take a peek at the operation, guys, and just kind of see what we've got available. I think I asked them. Yeah, I asked them half an hour ago if I could attack with all tanks, so I guess we're just gonna go ahead and go in, guys. What do we got here? Duality, Ballast, Quay. I think Quay was the one we did last time, so we'll do a different one. Work, right side. It's pretty simple. We'll take a look at Ballast. I'm not sure if this is a... Okay, he's got some boom cannons here. Yeah, I don't really like this one for tanks, guys. There's just too many cannons in range. It would take too much GB to smoke it all the way up, and we wouldn't have enough left to shock the cannons or anything. This one we could finish. 2 million shield. We should do that and see if the all-damage tanks can... Oh, current shield, only 20,000. No, that's boring. That's boring. We'll do a... We'll try to find a semi-challenging one here. Ooh, this is a really good one for Zookas. You would just flare down, like, right there, and then walk up. You've probably seen Duality before, and then shock, shock, shock. This one kind of sucks, actually, because there's so many rocket launchers. Maybe we could take out, No, this kind of sucks for tanks, too, because there's, like, the Doom Cannon over here. The Boom Cannon's there, we gotta be worried about. And then when we get close to the core, there's a lot of these Boom Cannons here. Basically, anything with Boom Cannons is gonna, like, is gonna make using tanks impossible. We already looked at this one. We could do Quay again, but I mean, we already did it last time, so we might be able to finish Quay, maybe. Let's try Quay, guys. Let's try Quay. This time we'll go for a hashtag chicken solo. We'll go for the chicken solo, guys. Okay, so we're boosted on up. We're diving on into Quay, guys. We're back. It probably would have been worth it to bring the medics. So we're gonna be flaring down. We're gonna be using them just like Zookas here on the landing. I should have put them closer because they're so freaking slow. Okay, back. Alright, so we're slowly crawling our way forward, guys. Now, is that flamethrower gonna be gonna touch any of them? Alright, so we just missed it. Oh, no, we didn't. Alright, so now we're going to be going way up here. Now, the problem with using tanks and operations, obviously, is going to be the time factor. It's kind of the same with Scorcher tanks. I've talked about that before, where it's like you want to be kind of ready to flare the core within, like 2 minutes of the time expiring. Oh, might have to let a hashtag chicken sneeze fly here in a second, guys. Okay. We're going to take down this... Cannon, 1, 2, 3. I think that's what it needs. 2 barrage and 3 artillery. Okay. Probably could have done that with better aiming. But yeah, you see the difference on the health on even on just on Stronghold. Like, that's ridiculous. You can't really take out specific defenses, especially like a shock launcher or something that's gonna have like massive health. You're kind of just stuck with what you got. Okay, so we're not worried about farming up GBE because we don't have the time for it again. So what the plan here is going to be, I'm going to throw some critters up here and here, distract those cannons in that sniper tower. Okay, so we're going to be making our way around here. Okay, I missed the cannon, that's going to hurt us. I want to out-heal those rockets and the mortars. They're not going to do a ton of work, but they are going to add up over time. I'm going to shock there, and I'm going to shock here. And I'm going to health. And I'm going to flare the core here, guys. Okay, we got to shock that rocket launcher. Oh, I missed the shock launcher. That's going to hurt us. So we're probably not going to have enough time to blast through the core completely, but we did get some work done. You see, bringing Scorchers, or if I had medics right now, I probably would have been able to finish it, but a shock launcher might be out of range of the ones on the far right, so depending on how much damage those rockets are doing, I can't really tell. Yeah, that shock launcher is really kind of screwing us up. Even the shock launcher's doing a bit of damage, that's crazy. So we got 2 tanks left. Yeah, so it doesn't look like we're going to be able to finish it, guys, but not bad for all tanks, right? Obviously, there's better ways to do it. But yeah, that's going to think that's going to do us in right there, guys. Oh, we'll go down clocking, though. We'll go down clocking. So let me know in the comments, too, what other challenges you guys would want to see. We got some really good ideas in the last one before we did it about, like, me and, like, Turtle, for an example. Like, we could do it with anyone, any other YouTuber you want to see. I'd be open to doing challenges with. oh, sure, we'll dive into another attack here, why not? There was another, someone posted in the comments and said that, we could, like, join the same task force. I forget if I talked about this already or not, but we could join the same task force and attack the exact same base with, like, find, someone that's, like, a leaderboard pusher or something. This isn't gonna work, guys. This is not gonna work. There's no way. We don't have any chance here with, he's got too much boosted ice and the doom cannons and stuff. We'll find a base that we can actually take down. But yeah, we had a really good idea when someone said that we could just, like, attack the exact same base and the same task force, which was, like, a really cool idea. So if you have any ideas like that, or, like, if there's people you want me to call out, let me know in the comments. Back. That grappler, the fire rate is just stupid. Like, it's just way too fast, in my opinion. Okay, so we're going to be working on these guys up here. I don't think this guy has any ice, so we shouldn't be losing. We shouldn't be losing any tanks, technically, but I'm just going to say we shouldn't lose too many. Okay. Let's go ahead and get the shock launcher out of the way. And this one. Okay, so now we've got basically nothing to worry about. We just have to out-heal the rocket launchers, and we're going to be good to go. Nothing else is really going to do any damage to us, guys. Yeah, I'm not worried about that mortar. I mean, they add up over time, especially in an operation, but generally you don't have to worry about mortars with tanks. Back. Alrighty. Okay, so we're walking on up. Walking on up, guys. Okay, so we're getting ready to take down the HQ. This should go down pretty easily. And yeah, definitely let me know in the comments how your tank mania is going. I think it would have been so much better if they did, like, a Scorcher tank mania. Or, like, a tank medic mania or something like that. Like, something you use tanks with. Like, they're fun to use on their own, but, I mean, they're just too slow, in my opinion, for map clearing. Okay, guys, so that's going to wrap it up for the video today, guys. Make sure to leave a like if you enjoyed the hashtag chicken hat and the lipstick for Turtle. And thank you again for the subscribers that have been here a long time. Big shout out to you, Martagician, and Everardo. Again, sorry for the wrong names. And yeah, that's going to wrap it up for the video today, guys. Make sure to leave a like if you found it interesting, entertaining, informative. Subscribe for more, and we'll see you in the next one, guys. Chicken out.